Okay, guys, we're going to take a joyride. I'll take you up and show you the mountain that's on fire.
Look at the roads.
Yeah. Got a gas station way down here. River, boy. Let's stock it with trout. Okay, guys, here's the mountain on fire.
So far.
You can see the hot water coming out over here. It's running down there. You can smell the sulfur like crazy, like rotten boiled eggs.
Uh-huh.
And that's because we're living under a volcano. And this is how they supply their electricity here. Farther on up the mountain is their power plant. They've got holes drilled down into it, and they use the steam to turn the turbines for the electricity. Last time we were here, this road was all gravel. We're going up a little farther. Coming right out of the road here.
Yeah.
Really coming out there.
People a lot like to stop and have a picture.
Yeah, everybody comes and
like natural
takes pictures. Yeah. Nice waterfall. Runs year round. And the last time, or the first time that we come up here, is we come by and stopped right up there was like a giant lizard.
Oh yeah.
It was like probably 1.5 feet long. And it ran right up to the top into the bushes. Beautiful river here, but there's no fish in it. Guys, about 10 years ago, this bridge didn't have any guardrails on it. In fact, there were no guardrails on this road at all, like the ones that you've seen us coming down. Well, about 10 years ago, a foreigner who was from Florida lived back up in the mountain here. And it had rained for about 3 days straight, very hard. And he got up, him and his wife, about 5 o'clock in the morning, was going to go to the market to get some meat. And he gets down here, and this river had flooded and was going across the top of this bridge. And apparently he assumed it wasn't that bad, and he tried to cross, and just as he got to the middle, it pushed his van off into the river here. And the next day, they found him and his wife floating at the mouth of the river in the ocean before it goes in. And after that happened, as you can see, they started putting all these guardrails up. So if they get a lot of rain, this river really rises up high.